shallow?
Shallow is not being steep.
Dude,
shallow.
Okay,
is
go, go. So to me, this is what I think shallow is. Shallow is here. So this is steep, right?
Okay.
Club is pointing vertically down, right? Shallow is more.
But
like
why
horizontal.
Is that steep?
Why is what steep? Why is this steep? Because it's steep angle of attack. Your arms are literally, instead of like kind of going like this, they're just going like that.
So here's the follow-up question. If you're here, right?
Yeah.
Could you all of a sudden undo this? Is that all of a sudden not steep?
Well, like getting here and then like kind of
like
doing that.
Yeah. Is that all of a sudden not steep?
Not necessarily. I mean, it's not steep anymore.
Right. Why?
Because you did a gnarly anti-steep move at the end.
What is that? Why is this not steep?
I mean, it sounds like an underflip.
Yeah, but why is underflip not steep? That's a good question.
I guess because underflip won't be steep because the heel isn't still pointing at the ball. So if you underflip it, the heel goes
correct.
Like this.
Correct. Yeah. So bottom line is, would you correct me if I'm wrong? If you go like this, right?
Yeah.
Would you say in order for you to unsteep it, all you have to do is match the head to the hand?
So.
Match it. I mean, like theoretically, right? We're talking about theoretically.
Yeah.
So, if.
Ooh, that was soft.
Oh.
So that's my question. If you, let's say you pull down.
Yeah, which is what I'm trying not to do.
Okay, but what if that's all you've done? That's all you want? You pull down a little bit.
Yeah.
Obviously,
show the camera.
Obviously, there's a combination of both. You can be around and shallow, and then be on top and shallow.
Yeah.
So I'm saying is.
Well, you'd want to be on top and shallow more than around and shallow.
It depends who you are, Blair.
Yeah.
Right? A guy like Todd Beck. He's on top and shallow.
Yeah.
A guy like Jordan Spieth or Alex Noren, he's around and shallow.
Okay.
Gigi's around and shallow. So there's basically two ways of shallowing, right? There's the horizontal plane, right? And then there's this way.
Yeah.
So if you want to shallow from up here, all you have to do is make sure that this matches this at impact. All of a sudden you're not shallow. But you're not steep. Why?
Right. I mean, I can't take it, does it? Yeah, because even though you're steep, then you're shallow.
Exactly. It's like,
which is why it bounces. Which is really good on certain short games.
Because the balance is exposed, right?
So yeah.
I can't be steep. If I was steep, I would dig, right?
Right.
Right? Now watch. I'm going to be steep right now. Watch.
Yeah, that's steep. That's like tomahawk chop.
So my question is, what's the difference, right? And then you can do it the other way, okay? Am I steep? Yes. Right?
Right, right.
But then, if I get it more around and under, like, if I get it even more this way, look. You're shallow.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying?
Well, how do you shallow?
So, exactly. I'm asking you.
Oh, asking me how I shallow.
I can't shallow this way, because I tried to.
You
for,
can't shallow
for
around.
Rolls.
You have to be covered. You have to be covered.
I can, but when I my speed doesn't come from around.
I feel
you're
like.
You rotate, like, you know how LPGA girls don't take divots?
Yeah.
Why? Why? No, but why? They're shallow, right?
Yeah.
They don't take divots, right?
Yeah.
So, how does it make them shallow but don't hit it around?
I mean,
because that would be like hitting a shot like this. That would be LPGA. That would be like this. Right? This is how they hit the ball. Correct? Shallow.
I mean, well, they shallow and they rotate.
Rotate,
yeah.
Correct. Rotation is what drives their body.
Yeah.
They have no vertical and no linear.
Yeah.
Meaning, no up and down. They just have this turn and turn. Correct?
Yeah, kind of like Molinari.
Yeah, Molinari has a little bit more, like, a little bit of hit.
Yeah, he has a little bit.
But he's pretty around. Yeah,
he's really around. Compared to the guys who hit it really far and, you know.
In relation to I don't know. I don't really think there's an actual, like, because of this, that's that. I think it's just how your body works.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Well, for me, when it comes to shallowing, I can't consistently time or do. If I come down, if I pull down, I don't think I can do this.
I think maybe you're a combination.
Wouldn't I be caught between two
no,
swing classes?
No. Because the best swings are a little bit up and a little bit around. Like
right.
Justin Rose.
Yeah.
He's not completely around. a little bit depth, and that's like Rory. He goes up.
Yeah, and then he's shallow.
So he's here. So he's shallow here and here.
Yeah.
So it's like the best of both. In a perfect, the best ball striker, like, they need it.
Right.
Because,
I think so.
Because when you're shallow this way, that means depth, rotation. When you're shallow this way, it means linear.
Right.
Linear. You can drive towards the ball. This is here.
Yeah.
If you're here, you're more.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So if you're in the middle, then you're both.
So you're telling me I should try to almost
because
do both?
I think you're both, to be honest.
Okay. We'll start with.
I think you've done too much, especially with short game. You need to be more.
Right.
Do you know what I mean? What's it, how different is that?
That was pretty good.
It's different, huh?
Yeah. Well, I'm still thinking what you told me where, you know, one for all, I can't be close to the target and then try to shout because I'm boned. So open it up a little bit, and then you were saying try to get it feeling like here. That way I can kind of do a mix of both.
You're here, and then you
get
out.
Yeah, because I get here, and then
you can go,
my pull down naturally puts it into
it's
a shallow
exactly. You
spot.
Go here. See, it's funny because Rose's pre-shot routine is a pull down.
Yeah. He does that
is
all
that
the time.
Funny?
He goes.
Yeah. He's like pulling down.
Yeah.
So essentially, when you do.
So he's anti me.
He's anti you.
Yeah.
So he essentially is trying to get less probably rotational and more pull down. So he can get more on top of it. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So a perfect example would be like Ricky Fowler.
Well,
he's
he
like,
it
looks
down.
Like he steeps, right?
Yeah, because he gets like
because
here
he's
and
so
he
deep
yeah.
and around.
Yeah.
He goes like this, right? And then
yeah.
you go like Sergio, he's
up and then down, yeah.
So it depends on which way you move first.
Well,
do you move rotationally first, or do you move linearly first?
Those are solid.
There you go.
You see
4 feet.
I mean, I'm not trying to physically do this move.
I know. Well, I see. The thing is, I'm like trying to physically do it.
That's. I don't know if that's good though, because you're a linear guy.
So I need to figure out a way to be
because
linear and shallow.
Exactly. So linear shallow is this, like loop.
So
you
want
you
me to feel
about?
Almost like I'm kind of. If I have my pull down, obviously I don't
want to
be like
pull down.
Well, I'm just doing whatever's natural. So if I naturally do this, I gotta be like that.
Exactly.
Okay. Just give it a try.
Exactly. And then the more you can get it this way, almost laid off looking, freaky looking, the more you can get on front.
Right. That makes sense.
Like a Thomas Peters.
It's like indigenous Sergio.
How's that?
That's solid. The only reason I listen to this guy is because he's a really good wedge player, by the way. And I'm really struggling with my wedges right now. My last tournament I had 5 shots inside of 100 yards. I missed 2 greens, hit everything short right, so I'm really struggling.
You gotta know who you are. Because I did shallow this way. I'll go here.
Okay.
I did try to do this way, like I can do it, but it's not like you mean this way, right?
Yeah.
Like, I can do it, but I just don't know where it's going.
It's like a lot more body rotation.
It does. It's still pretty good, though.
But I don't feel like I can get that set, like the ball flight isn't, I can't be, like, creative.
So you can't hit that little skipper if you need to do
I
it?
I can't be, like, creative with it. It's just, like, a stock. You know what I mean? It's, like, very, like, okay, I get a setup like this around, and that's it. Like, I don't know. I can't judge it off the lie.
It looks pretty good, though.
Oh, I know. It's but see how there's less creativity to it?
So the whole point is of this little video segment is to find out your way of shallowing the club.
Exactly.
What you do from swings, you know, you look at your full swing and you kind of see what you naturally do from the top and then apply that into the short wedge shots to then shallow it from whatever you do from the top.
Because, like, there is no right way. There's no, like, right way of but people define shallow, like, so generically.
Yeah.
Like, dude, you need a shallow. Well, no shit. Shallowing's the best. Well, how? Which one?
Right.
How, it's a combination of both.
Makes
there's
sense.
There's not one way that's right. You know what I mean? Like, there's certain ones that work better with certain shots. Bunker shot, it's hard to be around a shallow.
Yeah.
You're going to probably
chunk the crap out of it.
Absolutely perfect.
Yeah.
Driver is probably really good around shallow. Why? You come in and you can hit up more.
Yeah.
You can be this way more. Right? The John Rahm shot.
Makes sense.
So it's
there's not why there's not like a perfect way of shallowing. There's definitely certain ways of better shallowing, you know.
But you have to do whatever's natural to you. Yeah.
Because golf isn't about hitting every shot perfect.
Yeah.
It's putting like the ball where your strengths are and being able to score with your strengths. You guys will see in the last few shots that I had filmed when Sam was talking to me, getting really like low and deep, trying to kind of shallow from a really deep angle. That's like impossible. So I'm trying to get this thing more in front of me and shallow it. Stance a little more open.
Shoulders
are open.
There you go.
Ooh, there it is.
And then have the wedge a little bit more this way.
Okay.
Exposed to balance.
The bounce isn't like that?
No, like at the address. You're like too square.
Oh, okay.
So look how open my...
Yeah. If you guys can hear that, he wants me to expose the bounce a little bit more too.